Father, we want to thank you for this time. We so amazed at the beauty of your creation. Truly, we can fathom on those beauty that you have created this earth to be. And we continue to thank you for this day that you are going to guide us to open our hearts and minds to see the beauty of your creation. Lord, as we study and learn about what you have done on this earth, Lord, open hearts and minds to receive all these things. And that we will follow the rules that you have given us, the principles that you have given us, according to what you intend this earth to be. Lord, bless our fellowship together. Bless every one of us, and even the family that we have left back home. Bless them, protect them from harm, from any attacks of the enemies upon their lives. Protect them, O Lord. And all these things, we thank you. In the mighty God, we praise and we worship you. Amen and amen. Okay, again, who am I? Forgot to introduce myself last night. I'm Andrelyn. Chirai will also be our my assistant in this seminar. So if you have also concern, you can also go to him. Her? Okay. Now, who am I? I'm Andrelyn, by the way. I've been teaching natural farming for more than 15 years. That's why I'm authorized to teach it. I attended 3 times with Dr. Chohan Q. Chohan Q is the father of natural farming. This is the guy. The one with in red. Yeah, that guy. That's his daughter. I attended 3 times under Dr. Cho. The first time is in the late 1999. Then after that, 2007, I went to Jeju Island in Korea and attended again a seminar there. And the last seminar that I attended under Dr. Cho is in 2013 when he came back to the Philippines and conducted a seminar in San Fernando, La Union. In these 3 seminars that I attended, I was able to completely grasp natural farming. So that's why when I teach you natural farming here, it's almost complete at what Dr. Cho is teaching. But we contextualize it in the Philippine setting. So there are some program that we add on to the teaching which they don't have, but because of our conditions in the Philippines. Okay, so you will know all these things. Okay, now, so I'm also working with Babs. You see my shirt, Babs. Babs is Bureau of Agriculture Product Standards. So this is the bureau in the under Department of Agriculture who is doing drafting the standards of organic agriculture. And also, I also am a technical working group under Babs in the accreditation of certifiers. So it means OCCT, NYSARD, who is certifying for organic agriculture, we are the one who gives them the authority to certify. So we check them in their way of certifying farms that are approved organic. So we are the technical working group. Okay? So these are the credentials that I have in this regard. So you could see that I'm authorized to teach natural farming. Okay. Now, so before we go, I would like to to give you a bird's eye view of what is organic agriculture. By the way, in the international market, there are two agricultural programs. One is the conventional farming, which you all know. For more than since Green Revolution, the time of Marcos, we have been taught by Americans. It's an American technology. We are taught by the Americans about the Green Revolution. What is this? This is conventional farming. What is this conventional farming? Conventional farming is they teach us to apply urea 0060 and yon phosphorus, so NPK. No, they teach us also to use pesticide, fungicide, herbicide, monolocide. It's relative to suicide and genocide. So they are just relatives, the side family. The side family. So that's why you could see that it's not right. It's not right to use those things because they kill you. And we are taught of that. We are taught of that. Now, I want to settle this with you guys. Conventional farming is not the way to farm. Listen, guys. Conventional farming is not the way. Hindi paraan para magsasaka. Because it destroys. Come on, guys. And these are taught by the Americans. I'm not against them. I'm just against what they teach us. Which is wrong. Can you spray a chemical on a food and tell your children to eat? Simple as that. Illustration. Di ba? I-spray mo ang chemical, tapos papakain mo sa anak mo. Tama ba yan? It's wrong. And we learn it. Even in college, we learn all these things. Who are agriculturists here? Eventually, siya. And who else? You. What is your responsibility? So you were taught in college all these things. So, like Chirai, also is an agriculturist. So you were taught everything about these things, but you were never taught about creation. What is there? What are the things that are there that you need to preserve? No. Because in conventional farming, you kill everything.
Application of fertilizers, commercial fertilizers.
You kill everything. So that's conventional farming, guys. So, tama ba? Since Green Revolution up to now, the farmers are still poor. Did we get rich? No. Now, why is it that conventional can earn money? Yes, it can earn money. How? How? In conventional farming, you have to go to volume to earn. That's why you cannot earn in 1 hectare. You cannot earn in 2 hectares. You cannot earn even in probably 3 hectares. You have to go to 10, 20, 30 hectares to earn big. But how can small farmers go to 10 hectares and apply 10 hectares? Come on. Where can they get the money to apply 10 hectares? So, guys, that's why in conventional farming, you have to go big scale. You cannot earn in small scale. So, all poor farmers are left out. They cannot earn. That's why I'm going to give you another technology that you can earn even in small scale. Oh, is that okay? Is that okay for you guys?
Yes.
Even in small scale, kaya na kayong kumita. you don't need to go big scale. But from the small scale, you earn and you will expand and go to big scale. Because you're the earning. Clear? Okay ba? Any question in this area? Now, what is organic agriculture? Organic agriculture is opposite the conventional farming. That's why those who have learned conventional farming have to initially forego what you have learned from college about those commercial conventional way of doing farming and bring in this new system into your vocabulary. Because it's completely opposite of what you understand about conventional and about organic agriculture. It's completely opposite. Clear? So anyway, but the problem in organic agriculture, there's a downside. Oh, may problema pala ang organic agriculture. No, what are the downside? What are the problems in organic agriculture? The problem in organic agriculture, there are many systems. Maraming sistema pag-apply ng organic agriculture. There are many systems in applying organic agriculture. Now, what are the systems? The initial technology that comes into the Philippines is called the organic farming system. That's why I don't like you to mention about organic farming. No, it's a technology. If you want to mention about organic, you need to know, you just said organic agriculture, not organic farming. Because organic farming is a technology. Now, what is this technology that initially comes to the Philippines? This is organic farming system. Now, how does this technology work? Very simple. It's just composting of waste. What are the waste in the farm? Sige, ano mga waste sa farm?
Manure
and
leaves.
Branches. So these are the waste. What organic farming do is to decompose all these waste. No, ibubulok. Decompose. They decompose all these waste and turn them into so-called basal fertilizer. So itong basal fertilizer, ito yung solid. Klaro ba? Clear? Clear? Basal fertilizer, ito yung solid. Now, this solid fertilizer, this is where you put it back to the soil. No, ibabalik niyo sa lupa. Now, the problem with this, the basal fertilizer, you throw it back to the soil. The problem with this is this. If your soil is dead through conventional farming, for a long, long time, conventional farming, what happened to the soil? It becomes acidic. Or in another word, the two nutrients of the soil is gone. The nutrients of the soil is gone. That's why it becomes acidic. The soil becomes acidic because there's no nutrients already in the soil. Now, to bring back the nutrients back to the soil, to help the soil becomes fertile, it takes time. Hindi immediate result. It doesn't have immediate result. That's why in organic farming, it's a slow pace. Slow result. Slow, you will see slow process, not immediate result. It will take you probably 2 seasons of your rice or 3 seasons of your rice to bring back the quality of the soil, to bring back the nutrients of the soil. Dugay ba? That's why they don't like organic farming. This is your reason. Yesterday when you told me organic farming in the first season, the yield dropped.
Why income?
Why income? Because that's the only way organic farm is doing, basal fertilizer. That's all. That's what organic farming is all about. The composting and throwing back to the soil. Okay? Now, the second technology that comes to the Philippines is biodynamic. Biodynamic. Now, what is this biodynamic? The biodynamic comes from Europe. What is this technology? This is more on a talking about the moon, the stars, the clouds formation, the months, the season. So that's what you learn in biodynamic. What is the best month to plant what kind of crops? That's why they have this calendar telling you every month what kind of crops that you should plant. Okay? So this is biodynamic. Now, one thing good about biodynamic is they have upgraded the organic farming. In biodynamic, it's not only basal fertilizer, it's not only composting of waste in the farm, but also they have this so-called foliar fertilizer. What is again foliar fertilizer? Again, guys, when I teach this, the seminar, I always use layman's term. I have to look upon you as grade one. Even though you are technical people, I look upon you as grade one. Because we have to start from grade one. Because we forgot that grade one topic, we go to college topic already. That's too far. We have to go back to grade one, the basic. Now, that's why if I use technical terms, sometimes the grade one don't understand. So I have to explain. Okay? So just bear with me in this area. Okay? Okay. Now, when I said foliar fertilizer, what does that mean? Foliar, in another term, is called the leaves. So you are spraying the fertilizer on the leaves. You give the fertility to the leaves. So that's why it's called foliar fertilizer. Claro ba? So that's why the organic farming was upgraded, because it's not only basal fertilizer, but it's now include foliar fertilizer. That is where the immediate result will be. Not the organic farming. Organic farming, it takes you a long time. But when you have the foliar fertilizer, that is immediate result. You will immediately see the result. That's the difference between organic farming and even biodynamic and even the technology now. No, the technology now in organic agriculture is not only the basal fertilizer. They have the basal fertilizer and the foliar fertilizer. That is the key ingredient. Now, another concern to have the most complete form on organic agriculture is about microorganisms, which also in biodynamic, they have that also. But not so much emphasized. But they have that also. Okay? Now, the third technology that comes to the Philippines is this one, this natural farming. Now, there are two natural farming advocates. One is from Japan, the other one from Korea. The one from Japan, his name is Fukuoka. You could see what is he promoting? Do nothing farming. Oh, you will like it. Do nothing. Wakay buhay. Do nothing farming. You will love it. Right? A farmer would love to do nothing farming. Diba? But that takes time. The do nothing farming takes time. Now, Fukuoka make a book, make a lot of book. One of the famous book that he produces is called One Straw Revolution. If you can buy that book, I challenge you to read it because everything that he taught in that book is about nature. About the principle of nature. About how nature heals itself. About nature producing itself without human intervention. So I like you to buy that book and read it because you will learn a lot from it.
It's available online.
It's in available. Amazon.
No, it's even for free you can get.
Yeah, you can get.
Because it's long, it was written a long time ago, so it's available for free.
Yes.
PDF.
What is the paper?
One Straw Revolution. Straw, rice straw. You can get it in internet also. Okay, now, so the one from Korea, Dr. Yang Sanko, Dr. So Han Kyu is his first name, So is his family name. So, Han Kyu So learned from the Japanese and develop the technology in Korean setting. That's why he was able to improve what he learned from Japan, especially in the area of microorganisms. Claro ba? Okay? Now, another technology that comes to the Philippines, anyway, you'll be learning a lot from the technology of Dr. Han Kyu So because of his seminar. Okay. Now, the next technology that comes to the Philippines is called the permaculture. Permaculture. Now, what is permaculture? Permaculture is more on landscaping. Di ba, meron, there is so-called part, no, sorry. Permaculture is more on farmscaping. Farmscape. Now, we heard about landscaping, right? To landscape land, to make it beautiful. Farmscaping is doing farm inventories, farm terrain, and how to, where to do the forest, where to do the fruit trees, where to plant your vegetables, where to put up your housing, where to put up your animal house, where to put up, if you have a pond, how to do the pond for fish. So these are being taught in permaculture. And in permaculture, they teach you alternative way of doing everything, like housing. They don't teach you the hollow block type, but they teach you the clay type housing, using the clay, using the soil as your basis for your wall. Yun ang tinuturo. And also, they teach you also solar energy, wind energy, so these are all alternative energy. Okay, so that's what you're going to learn in permaculture. Doing farm scaping. No? So if you bought a farm, you first do the farm scaping first before you apply your plants on the farm. Not keep on doing a lot of things in the farm, then suddenly after everything grows, you say, oh, I'm wrong. This should not be the place where I put up this one. But it's there already. So, ang sisi, nasa huli ang sisi. Okay? So, you farmscape first where to put up your forest. Huh? Where to put up your fruit trees. Where to put up your vegetables, where to put up your house, your piggery, your poultry, your livestock, your fishes, everything, farmscape before applying what you want to do. Clear? prayer.
Yes.
So that's the permaculture. And lastly, that we have introduced to the Philippines called the Jedam technology. Now, this is the son of Dr. Sohan Q. His name is Yang San So. So, Yang San So introduced Jedam. Now, what is Jedam? Very simple. So, he learned from his father, Dr. Farming. But the technology of his father, there are still some areas need to be improved. So, Yang San So improved the father's technology into more cheaper technology. If natural farming is already cheap compared to conventional farming, natural farming is already very cheap compared to conventional farming, but Jedam is more cheaper than natural farming. So that's why Jedam is called ultra low cost farming. That's why we are going to let you understand both technology. So we will tell you how to apply these two technology into one. Clear? So this is what you're going to learn the whole time that you are here. Excited?
Yes.
Excited na kayo?
Yes.
See, so we're going to teach you all this. Okay? Okay. Now, let's go to natural farming first. Natural farming. Natural, it talks about nature. Right? Right?
Yes.
So, ibig sabihin, kalikasan. No? It means, natural farming means using the nature as your tools to do farming. Again, using the nature as your tools to do farming. If you use the nature as your tools, nature are free, right? Right? Am I right? Nature are free.
Yes. Yes.
You don't buy the nature. It's free. So if we use the nature as your tools to do farming, then it means you spend less. Spend less because nature is free. Larva. Oh. So, but if you want to use the nature, you have to understand how nature works. Diba? Paano ba nag-work ang nature? How does the nature work? Now, to understand the nature, then you need to go back to who created it. Who created the nature? Kayo. Sino gumawa ng kalikasan?
God.
Not you. Not human being. It is God who created the nature. So we have to understand how God created it to understand how we can use them. Clear? Clear?
Clear.
So what we're going to do right now, I'm going to give you a Bible, short Bible study. So it's found in Genesis chapter 1. So for the Muslim, it's in Quran.
Chapter 1.
The Genesis, they have Quran. They have also in Quran, Genesis. Okay? Now this is the time when God created everything. Okay, now I will not go verse by verse. I just compile everything into one. Now I want you to open your hand up right now. Please. This one. Okay? First few pages of your handout. Yeah, man. Yeah. 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 Okay, you have it there? I call this cycle of nature. After. Yeah. Okay, I call this cycle of nature. Sa Tagalog, paikot sa kalikasan. Cycle of nature. Now, this will be your foundation. Oh, anong ibig sabihin? Foundation. Basic foundation. What do you mean by that?
Sukaran.
Tama. Mauna yung sukaran sa inyong pag-uuma. Okay? Now, so you have to understand this cycle by heart as much as possible. Because this will guide you in what you are going to do in the farm. Now, I will use this cycle of nature to discuss the creation in the Bible or in the Quran. Claro ba? Okay. Now, it says there, in the beginning, God created the heaven and earth. So, during that time, when God created the heaven and earth, it was so beautiful. But through the years, through many decades, there was a destruction. The scientists called it the Ice Age, or other they called it that there was a meteor accident that the whole earth was destroyed. So the verse 2 of Genesis chapter 1, it says, the earth was formless and void. Nasira, ibig sabihin. Guba. No? The whole earth was destroyed. So that's why walang ka-design-design. Okay? Later on, we'll discuss the condition of the earth. So God had to recreate. Ayusin ulit. Okay? Nasira eh. Naguba. So, it was destroyed. So, God had to recreate. To ayusin. Reconstruct. Thank you. To again reconstruct what was being destroyed. So during this time, the whole earth is in darkness, no light. So how can somebody work on a dark conditions? Wala. At night, when there is darkness, there's no moon, no stars. Too dark. How can you work? Am I right? So, what is the initial thing that God said? So that He can work. He said, let there be light. No, let there be light. So, initially, God created light. Now, what are the two lights that God created? Initially, God created the sun
and the moon
to brighten up the day, and the moon and the stars to brighten up the night. So that's the initial thing that God did. Initially, the morning, He created the sun to brighten up the day. Like ngayon, morning, you can see everything. And at night, even though at night time is very dark, He created the moon and the stars so that even during night time, there is some light. Okay? Okay. Now, so, daytime, nighttime, equivalent to one day. That's where our calendar started. So that's day one, year 0000. Okay? Okay. Now, so after that, the next thing that He did, He said, God created two bodies of water. God created two bodies of water. Initial bodies of water is on earth. During this time, the whole earth, in the Bible, it says, Quran, it says, the whole earth is covered with water. Walang lupa, no land. Only purely water. Now, that is the first body of water. Now, may I ask you, what kind of water is it? There are only two kinds of water. One is fresh water and salt water. Now, during this time, the whole earth is covered with water. What kind of water is that? He said sea water or salt water. How about the other? Salt water also. You are right. It's salt water. Now, this salt water is very salty. That's why during this time, there's no life. No life. Because it is very, very salty. Very salty, no life can be born. Very salty, no life can be born. If you go to Israel, there's so-called a Dead Sea. That Dead Sea is very, very, very salty. There's no life. Not even plants, not even microbes, not even fish can live in that area. That's why it's called Dead Sea, no life form. Okay? So that's the condition of the earth during that time, no life. Okay? Okay. Now, so that's the first body of water. What is the second body of water? Well, no water. That's the whole earth covered with seawater. So what is the second body of water? This is it. The sky. Very simple. The sun evaporates the seawater. And this water landed in the sky, in the clouds. And the clouds will process, will sterilize, disinfect, take out the salt, and when the water becomes heavy, it goes down as rain. Now this rain becomes fresh water. So when the water, when the rain came down to the earth, and because of the fresh water, what happened to the salt?
Becomes less.
Become less salty. Clara ba? Clear?
But when it evaporates, when it evaporates, the salt stays there, right?
Yes.
So if it comes back, the salt is still there.
Yeah, but it will lessen the saltiness. Because of the fresh water. Then again, it evaporates because of the sun, and it will disinfect again, it will less be salty again, take out the salt, and it comes down to fresh water again. So it's a cycle. So as the rain comes down, the less the salty will the water be. Because if it's too salty, no life can be formed. So he had to take away some saltiness of the water before he can bring in life. Clear? That's how intelligent God is. Okay? Now, then after that, I said the earth, there is no land. So what did God did? He separate the waters from the land. So there are lands already. There are mountains, valleys, hills, flat lands, and oceans. And the sun keep on evaporating the seawater, and the clouds cleanse the seawater and come down as rain. When the rain keep on coming down to the land, there are in the mountains, there are hollow area where the fresh water landed, so keep on filling it up with fresh water, and the whole vacant hollow area becomes what? Lakes. Fresh water lake. lakes. And the rain keep on coming in, so the lakes overflow. When the lakes overflows, it becomes river. Fresh water rivers. And the rivers goes to the ocean. So again, fresh water will slowly reduce the saltiness of the ocean. See? If you study the Bible, you should be creative. You should understand how God is doing it. So that you will know, because He had to bring in life. He cannot bring in life when it's too salty. So He had to reduce the saltiness of the sea. So this is the way He do it. Okay. So after there is land already, so it's time right now. Now, the rain, the fresh water, okay, it's like a big sprinkle to sprinkle on the soil so that because there is a need for the water to sprinkle on the soil. Because the next thing that he's going to do is he created right now vegetation. Vegetation, what you see right now, God created forest, God created fruit trees, God created herbal plants, God created grasses, God created vegetables. So all these need water. No? They need water. Now, there is already air, there is already wind during the time. Okay? Now, so, three things is crucial. The sun, the water, or moisture, or rain, and the air. These three elements is crucial to the things that he's going to do. Because all the plants, and even the life form that he's going to create later on, I'll be discussing that, they all need the sunlight, they all need the air, and they all need the moisture or water. Kailangan nila lahat yan before he created the vegetation. Okay, so you could see all the vegetation being coming up from the land and in the sea. The vegetation is not only on the land. He also created vegetation on the sea and even on the lakes. Lakes, there are vegetation on the lakes. There are also vegetation on the rivers. So all these things he created. Now, he said that all this vegetation are for food. Food. Pagkain. Now, what happened right now? The vegetation right now is not for food. It is for food to us, but less. Am I right? But during this time, God said, these are your main food, vegetation. But we make it secondary. Our main food right now is what? What? Meat. What is wrong?
Patay tayo, Pilipino nito.
Yummy. Yummy man. Our main food should be vegetation, not meat. That's our main food, the vegetation. Meat is our secondary food, not primary food. Klaro ba, mga kapatid? So, guys, God said even the vegetation is for your medicine. You get your medicine from the vegetation, not from the butika. That's conventional. For profit. That's company's profit. Multinational. That's not medicine for our body. Those are medicines for our body. Those food that God created, the vegetation. So after the vegetation, there is food already, so He created next life form. So nasa taas na tayo. Did you see the cycle? So, kanina nandito tayo, then we go to the vegetation, the food, and now we get the life form. So, God created, after He created the food, now He created the one that will eat the food. So, He created life form. So, God created birds in the sky, fishes in the sea, and animals in the land. Okay? Now, if all these life forms that God has created, and they are all eating vegetation, what will happen to the vegetation? Oh, come on.
They will decrease.
They will wipe out all vegetation.
Yes.
Am I right? Am I right? Mahurot. Ang vegetation, if all animals, if all life forms that God created, the birds in the sky, fishes in the sea, and animals in the land, all are eating vegetation, what will happen to the vegetation? It will completely wipe out all vegetation. So what did God do? God separate three divisions of food intake of life forms. The first category, three categories. The first category is called the vegetarian group or herbivore group. They are the vegetarian group. These animals only eat on the veggies, on the plants. Now, you will know the category by the structure of their teeth. By the structure of your teeth, you will know what category they belongs to. Now, if they are vegetarian or herbivorous group, their teeth will be completely be flat, like what our back teeth are. Yung likod ng ngipin, flat. Flat teeth up the front, everything are flat. Then, they are herbivorous group. Mga vegetarian sila kung puros flat yung ngipin. Klaro ba? So, you will understand your animals what kind of food that they take by the structure of their teeth. Kabalunan nyo kung unsang ginakaon nila. Okay. The next category is called the carnivorous group or carnivore. This group of animals eat on meat. Eat on meat. Now, what is the structure of your teeth, of their teeth? From the back to the front, they are all sharp. They are all sharp. Walang flat. No flat teeth. All are sharp teeth. That's why they are carnivorous group. The third group of animals is called the omnivorous or omnivore. This group of animals can eat both plants and meat. Now, what kind of teeth do they have? They have both flat and sharp. They have both flat and sharp. Like for example, ang baboy, the pigs, they have both flat and sharp. So they are omnivore. Like human being, we are
omnivore.
Now listen, huh? Look. How many sharp teeth does human being have?
Four.
Let's count it so that we won't quarrel already after the seminar. It's hard that we, after the seminar, we keep on quarreling on the, how many sharp teeth we had. Let's count it right now and settle the problem right now. No? Let's count. One, two, one pair, three, four, two pairs, two or four, you're right. Yeah. Because you didn't say pair or pieces. Okay? So, with so many teeth, we only have two pairs of sharp teeth. So, what does God telling us? God is telling us, yes, I allowed you to eat meat, but that is not your main food. Your main food is still vegetation. That is your main food. Meat, yes, I give you, but there are limited food that you can eat also. Not all animals you can eat. Even pork is not eatable. That's why they are right. We touch that later on third day when we touch on livestock, okay? But we are used to it already. We cannot control ourselves not eating pork. But again, guys, I'll discuss that in the livestock, okay? The Seventh-day Adventists are also right. The vegetarians are somewhat right and wrong, because you cannot be 100% vegan. God allows us to eat meat because there are meat that we, our body need for the nutrition that is found in meat, not found in plants. Okay? Now, that's why we have sharp teeth. That's the purpose of that sharp teeth. Okay? Now, going back. So the after the life forms, what happened? Very simple. The vegetation and the life form, there are waste that comes out from them. Again, the vegetation and life form, there are waste that produce from them. Merong basura na gikan sa mga vegetation at sa mga life form. Now, what are these waste? What are the waste? You see that? Pulses, urine, dead bodies come from the life form, and leaves, woods, and overripe fruit come from the vegetation. Now, both of them, both of them have waste. It's not on vegetation alone, it's not on life form alone. Both of them have waste, and these are the waste that they produce, both of them. These waste will go back to the soil. These waste will go back to the soil. Now, listen. The question I'm going to ask you. What is the best fertilizer for the vegetation? Again, what is the best fertilizer for the vegetation?
Yung mga waste na na-decomposer.
Waste from the
vegetation and the animals.
Vegetation. The right answer is the best fertilizer is the for the plant is the plant itself. Again, the best fertilizer for the plants is plant itself. Naintindihan niyo? Now, how about the animal waste? Animal waste comes from where?
From the plants.
From the plants. They eat the plants. If they eat the animals, the animals that they eat, that animals eat the plants also. So everything boils down to the plants. The best fertilizer is the plant itself. There's no other best fertilizer but the plant itself.
Yung fecal sample ng human cell, it's not advisable.
Listen, because we are under a law. A law is not perfect. In other countries, they use spices already, human waste, as fertilizer. In the Philippines, it's because of our culture. It's not because it's not right. It's because of our culture. We don't like human waste to be a fertilizer. But for animal waste, it's okay. But what's the difference between human and animal waste? They are all waste. They eat vegetables. They eat meat. They're the same. It's waste. It's just a culture. Ano, hindi.
Kasi sir, mas odorous yung
no.
Sample ng human, sir.
No! Ay, look at the piggery farm, poultry farm. Isn't it? It's odorous. Oh, ammonium is odorous. Everything is odorous. All the waste are odorous. That's why you have to process it so that it will not have the odorous smell. If your waste is odorous, it means there's a problem in the liver. No kidding. Kumabaho ang human waste mo. You have problems already in your liver because your liver cannot process the right amount. That's why when it comes out, it is still rotten. Rotten is odorous because it's not processed thoroughly. Because in our system, our livestock, the piggery and poultry, no smell.
No smell. Using organic.
Yes. Microorganism. We'll touch that later on. See? So what's the difference between a human waste and animal waste? It's the same. They are all waste. They eat also what we eat. Except right now, none eat a lot of toxic. They eat antibiotics, conventional. They eat preservative. They eat a lot of chemicals. Yes, we eat a lot of chemicals. Do you believe me?
Yes.
Yes. Those people that spray on your the plant, the chemicals, who are eating them? That's why they don't want the human waste to be fertilizer. It's because of that mind view, mindset. Pero kung animal, but what's the difference? They are both ways. It's just a perception in your mind. Clear? Because we are bound by the law, so we have to follow the law. We cannot use human waste. But in our ancestor, when they want to practice their bowel movement, they go to the land where it is a little covered, shaded. They dig a hole and do their thing, and close down the hole. Leave it. That's what they did in our ancestor. Am I right?
Yes.
And those manure, those waste becomes fertilizer. It is now we are so much so clean. Think of clean, but still there are ways.
Okay, I wonder why the government or other agriculturists does not require us to use human.
Because there's a law still. In the organic law, human waste cannot be used as fertilizer.
Pero the former mayor of Tamil City, sir, we interviewed him. They use fecal sample their thesis for durian,
No one can tell you not to use human waste, but you cannot certify that as organic under the organic law. But you can use human ways. But you cannot certify it as organic. We use human ways. Because under the law of our local laws, of organic law, you cannot use human ways. But you can use human ways in
your own farm.
Yes! But you cannot certify it as organic.
Yes!
Tama na.
Well, do you rain for good, sir? I think it's a good fertilizer. And
yes!
Kisishani.
Yes! Even cow, even goat, even everything. Even human. Clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now. So the best fertilizer is what?
From the plant.
The best fertilizer for the plants is the plant itself. Nasabot na niyo? Clear? We'll go to that more details later on. I'm just giving you a bird's eye view right now. Okay, now, I told you a while ago that the waste from the vegetation and waste from the life form, which is this one, will go back to the soil. Will go back to the soil. In the soil, they solve all these microorganisms. Now, what is microorganism? Now, we go back to high school time. Biology class. I hate that subject. But now I love it. Why? Because I understand now the importance of that subject. Okay. Microorganism. What are microorganisms? Listen. Microorganisms are very tiny life forms that God has created for a purpose. If you want to know the design of figures of microorganisms, you cannot see it in your eyes. Hindi mo magamit ang mata, makita mo ang microbes. Kahit may kayo sila, you need to use a microscope. Okay? Now, not all microscope can distinguish all microorganisms because there are a lot of microorganisms that are smaller than that you can see sa microscope. Ibig sabihin, napaydaghang mga mikrobyo mas gamay pa katong magamit mong microscope na makita mo sila. So, hindi makita sa microscope. So, you need a more powerful microscope to be able to identify more smaller microorganisms. And this microscope is called the electronic microscope, where you can zoom in more smaller microscope. But, again, even the most powerful electronic microscope cannot still distinguish smaller kind than that you can see in the most powerful microscope. Kita ninyo? What do I mean by this? Even the scientists are saying, we only know 10% of the nature. Again, the scientists are saying, we only know 10% of the nature. 10% lang kabalo nila ang mga scientists. How about the 90%? Are we going to throw it away? Are we going to throw away the 90%? It's a bigger percentage, 10% against 90%. So this is where I'm going to teach you selective BS solution. Selective BS position, you have to keep on understanding this principle of selective against policing. Selective means you just choose. Policing, it means you embrace everything. Klaro ba? Selective, ibig sabihin na pili ka lang. Pila-kabok lang, pila-pila lang sila. Yan ang ibig sabihin ng selective. Policing, it means you embrace everything, even you don't know everything. Narinig niyo? Even you don't know everything, you just embrace everything. Because if man knows everything already, then they are God already. You cannot be like God. Now, this is the reason why I'm going to challenge you. Don't buy things that are selective in the sense. Again, don't buy things that are selective in a sense. Ibig sabihin, pinili lang. You just choose this one, this one, this one, this one, and package it into one, and sell it to you. Because you are throwing away a lot of other things that are needed. Clear?
Yes.
Very simple. 10% against 90%. Come on, guys. And if you just use 10%, you are going to create a havoc in the environment. If you just use 10%. Diba? 10% lang ang ilagay mo. When there are 100% that you can use, you just use 10%. So you are going to increase the 10% in the environment. That's dangerous. How about the 90%? You are going to decrease them. That is wrong. In the environment, there is another word that you need to understand. The word is synergy. Two words. Synergy and what's the other one? They are related to one another. Symbiotic relationship. Okay? So, synergy, symbiotic relationship. They need one another. The whole creation need one another. You cannot just select just few and throw it back. Symbiotic relationship. They need one another. You cannot forgo just a few of them. They need all. That's why we're teaching you holism, not selective. Claro ba? The scientists will sell you selection. Selective. Because they know what they are getting. See? But that's dangerous. The scientists should keep on looking on the environment and try to come up with what is there in the environment and what are their functions, but not to create in the environment something to send it to you and tell you to apply it. That's wrong because you are going to destroy the symbiotic relationship. You are going to create a havoc in the environment. That's why there are many diseases that comes out, new diseases that are coming out, because of that havoc that man is trying to do. Clear? We are the creation of what is happening to us right now. All the diseases, all the sickness and everything. We are the creator of those, not God. Okay. Now, so what are the functions? of microbes. So I'll give you some functions, not all. Because, again, we cannot know all. But what the scientists discover, we will discuss it so that you will see how they work in the environment. Functions of microbes. Number one, they are feeders. Feeder. Anong ibig sabihin ng feeder? What do you mean by feeder? Anong ibig sabihin ng feeder? Sila yung BSWD.
Ah.
They are feeder. They feed the plants. They feed the plants. Bago ito sa inyo, no?
Sa amin
kasi
ang microbes
is the composer. We'll go to that later on. First,
feeder.
When you are in college, have you learned that? You learned that?
No.
You were taught that the plants eat nutrients. But you were never taught that who delivered the nutrients to the plants?
The microbes.
The microbes. The microbes are feeder. They feed your plants. They bring nutrients to your plants. Before I used to teach, feed the soil, and the soil will feed your plants. Now I change. I said right now, feed the microbes, and the microbes will feed your plants. Not the soil. Because the microbes are the one who delivers the nutrients to the plants. Claro na. That's why in conventional farming, it's not very effective. Because why? Because you kill the microbes. You kill the microbes. When you kill the microbes, so less food are being brought to the plants. It was by force that you feed your plants. You will know that when I discuss the urea on the third day. Tomorrow. You'll know it. Because it's force feeding. The plants react to something. Not because the microbes are delivering food. It's because of the plants. They were forced to do something. Tomorrow you'll know it. You're learning a lot now, huh?
Agriculture, sir, wala ito.
Wala! You don't learn that.
The plants, no. It's the fertilizer.
That feeds the plants.
It feeds the plants.
Yeah. You'll know that later on. You'll know that later on. Okay. Now, so, why does the microbes have to feed the plants? Bakit ang mikrobyo kailangan pakain sa tanong? Why? What's the reason behind that? Why should the microbes feed the plants? Because of this word, symbiotic relationship. What is this symbiotic relationship between the microbes and the plants? What? Okay, this is the relationship. The microbes have to feed the plants so that the plants will produce a food to feed the microbes. Oh! Symbiotic relationship. Again, the microbes have to feed the plants because the plants will produce a food that will feed the microbes. What is the food of the microbes?
Plants.
No. Sugar. Sugar. Sugar is one of the main food of the microbes.
Molasses.
Yeah.
Molasses.
Nasabot na inyo. So you are getting already. Huh? So, the microbes had to kill the plant so that the plant will feed the microbes. Clear?
Yes.
So symbiotic relationship. So if the plants, if the microbes do not feed the plants will not produce the sugar for the microbes. So they were forced to feed the plants so that the plants could produce the food for the microbes. Clear? So that's number one, feeder. Second, builder. Builder. So, mga construction worker pala itong microbes. Ha? Huh? These microbes are construction workers. So, they are builders. What do they build? What do they build? They build your soil. They build the soil. Now, remember, when we talk about soil, mostly in the Philippines right now, because of too long of conventional farming, what happened? The topsoil are eroded. So what is the second soil base after the topsoil, which is fertile soil? What do you call that, the second layer of the soil? They call that clay loam. Am I right? You study that. Tama ba? Clay loam. What is a clay loam soil? What is a clay loam soil? No! Clay loam soil are hard. When it's dry, it's like stone. It's very hard. Gahi. That's clay loam. So if your soil is very hard, what happens? Air cannot go in. Your plants, the roots is in the soil. They need air. So if there are less air, the roots will become weak. Klaro ba? The roots become weak. Okay? Now, if your clay loam soil is hard, when it rains, what happens? It cannot absorb too much water because it's
clay.
It is compact. So what happened?
Less water. Flood.
What happened? Baha. Flood.
Floods and erosion.
Erosion is part of it, but what you are going to see is flood. Because it cannot absorb too much water. Clear? Nakuha niyo? Yeah, grabe ang magbaha, ang yuta mo, if your soil is clay loam, you'll see a lot of flooding. Because the soil cannot absorb too much water. Because they are compact. Yes. Clear? Okay. Now, so what does the microbes do? The microbes aerate it. Buhakan. How? They build the soil. How? The microbes releases a substance. This substance is a glue substance. Glue. Ang ibig sabihin glue? Pandikit. Glue. Glue substance that will bind the clay soil. That will bind the clay soil. When the clay soil bounded, becomes what? Pebbles. Small soil base. Not rocks. They bound and becomes sand. Yeah. Maging bubo siya. So if the clay soil becomes bind, what happens? The soil erates. Balod. Di ba? Buhaghat. Maging buhaghat. The clay soil becomes erate. Buhaghat. What's buhaghat sa English? Poros. Becomes porous. So when the soil becomes porous, so air can easily comes in. Am I right?
Yes.
Para sa bato ba? Kung daghang bato, hindi ba magpasok ang hangin na? No? So air can easily goes in. And when your soil is porous, when it rains, the water will go deep. Am I right? So madali ma-absorb ng tubig ng yuta. So you will have less flooding. Nakita niyo? So water will go into your soil. When water goes into your soil, you will have already water in your lower parts of the soil. So when it's famine, you are not afraid. When it's too much rain, you are not afraid. Because water will just go into the deep of the soil. When your soil is porous. Am I right? So that's what, that's the second work of the microbes. They are builders. The third one, they are soldiers. Oh, anong ginagawa ng military? Anong ginagawa ng military? They protect from terrorism, from attacks. They protect the citizenry. Minsan, hindi, no? Mga ano yun? Kalawang. Okay? But the responsibility of an army or soldier is to protect. Am I right? Now, what does the microbes protect? What do they protect? They protect the plants from attacks. They protect the plants from attacks. Sino naka-attack sa plants? Mga sakit, mga viral, bacteria, peste. So they protect the plants from attacks. Wow! Look, just this tree alone, just this tree purpose of the microbes, 50% of the problem of your farm is solved already. Am I right? Itong tatlo lang na character ng microbes, ang function nila. Just these three functions of the microbes, 50%, more than 50% of your problems in the farm is solved already. Am I right? Nasabot na. Sobrang 50% solved na. Pero sila nagdadala ng pagkaon, sila nagpapagwapo sa yuta, sila yung nag-protect ng yuta. See, just these three functions, they feed the plants, they bind the soil so that they become arid, and they becomes the soldier to protect the plants from the attacks. Just these three purposes of the microbes, you already solved a lot of problems in your farm.
So you said they protect the plants from attacks such as viral, bacterial, and
diseases.
See? Tapos na ang problema ninyo. Microbes pa lang. Kaya in the lecture, in our lecture, microbes is the crucial point. Microbes are the crucial, important factor in what you are going to do in the farm. What you need to do in the farm is to increase the microbes in your farm. Do not kill them through chemicals, but feed them with all the plants that they need. Clear? Clear? Another function is they decompose. Now again, I'm just going to give you some functions, not all, because we cannot know all. Claro ba? Yung kabalo lang nato, what we know about their functions, this is what we're going to teach you. We cannot teach you all because we don't know all. We just know what we know. That is what we're going to give you. We cannot know everything because we will be God if we know everything. Okay? Now, so, they are the composer. Now, they decompose all those ways. They turn all those ways into new three yens. Again, they turn all those ways into new three yens. Ang ginagawa ng mikrobyo, dinedecompose nila lahat ng mga basura niya. Pag na-decompose ng basura, magiging sustansya o new three yens. Okay? Now, and when these microbes, good microbes, beneficial microbes, are the one decomposing, you will see they will not create foul odor. Again, if the beneficial microbes are the one decomposing this way, you will never smell foul odors. Kung ang beneficial microbio ang mag-decompose sa mga basura niya, wala kang maaamoy baho. Oh, yun pala, magtanggal ng baho. No? That's how you take away bad odors.
That's why we have to spray the IV odor for the
Claro ba? Claro? Now, when they decompose all these waste, they become nutrients. And the scientists divided these nutrients into macro and micro nutrients. What do you mean by macro and micro nutrients? Macro means more, mas daghan. Okay? Micro means mas gagmay, small amount. Macro, bigger amount. So, micro, smaller amount. Now, listen carefully. Does it mean that you don't need the micro? A micro?
No. We need the macro.
Again, I said the macro means plenty, micro means less. Does that mean you don't need the micro?
You need.
They also need it. They are equally important to the macro. Even though micro are smaller amount, but they are equally important. Which the conventional farming changes the mindset. Oh, you don't need so much on the micro. Micro. You just need majority macro. Now, if you are doing macro, which is what? NPK, that's the macro. So in conventional farming, they focus a lot on these three. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
NPK. Now, if you have these three, NPK, what does this NPK do? Very simple. N means they grow the plants. Grow, for growing. P means they flower the plants. The plants will flower. Okay? K means they fruit the plants. The plants will fruit. So in conventional farming, they said, oh, we want to produce wood, so we just need these three. It's good enough. Because in N, you grow the plants. In P, you flower the plants. In K, you fruit the plants. That's what we want, the fruits. So what else do we need? We don't need micro.
Yes, and I mean agriculture, we don't need micro. Yeah. We need macro nutrients.
Yeah. So when you in conventional farming, we focus a lot on this macro. We less focus on the micro. But remember what did I say? Micro and macro are equally important. Even though a macro is more, micro is less. But it doesn't mean that micro is less important. No, it's equally important to macro. Because this completes the nutrients. Now, what does I mean by that? It means last night what I said to you, high quality means what? Healthy food. Our goal here for the farmers is that they will produce healthy food. Not just food alone. If you want to produce food, just the macro, you can produce food. But if you want healthy food, then those two are equally important. Claro ba? You're clear? If you just want to produce food, go ahead. A lot of ways of producing food. But if you want to produce healthy food, then there will be an issue already. How good quality is your production? Gaano kaganda kalidad ang inyong production? Kaya bang mag-produce ng healthy food or no?
Kaya, sir. Through our backyard, food for home, by applying organic.
We'll go to that. That's why when you are talking about healthy food, it's a different system. But if you're going to just produce food, then MPK is finished. Just that. Clear?
So, in conventional farming, if they just use NPK, the plant will grow and
bear fruits.
Fruits. With NPK only?
Yes.
NPK only. Ah.
So then you don't need the soil. You can just do it in
Yes. That's why that's hydroponics.
Ah.
You can do hydroponics without the soil. Yeah. So it's up to you. What you want to do? You want to produce healthy food? Then you have to do it the way God intended it to do. Then you will have healthy food. You have to follow God's principles, God's ways, God's design how to produce healthy food. Not man's way, man's design.
So the problem with using conventional farming, if you use NPK, that means they don't have the microbes that will protect the plant.
See, look. Yeah. We have a lot of people eating three meals a day, even five meals. Right now you're going to eat five meals a day.
Mm.
And when you go to a doctor, the doctor examine you, they will tell you, oh, you lack vitamins. So they prescribe a multivitamins. What are listed there? Micronutrients.
Mm.
Calcium, copper, iodine, iron, magnesium, manganese, zinc, boron, molybdenum, etc., etc., etc. Those are in the multivitamins.
Which is not in the plant.
Because it's not in the plant.
Yeah.
That's why if you keep on eating, it doesn't mean you are eating healthy food. You're eating nutritious food for your body. You lack nutrients. Every one of us, we lack nutrients unless we eat healthy food. You see? that's one man invention, multivitamins. Too much multivitamins in the shelves of healthy bath stores. Because we lack multivitamins. And that is crucial to health. Without the multivitamins, we will have a lot of sickness. We will be showing you videos anyway. Clear? Okay? Now, where are these microbes? Where can you find microbes?
In the sugar.
Let's go first. You can find microbes initially in the air. So in the air, there are many kinds of microbes lying in the air. So we go here first, in the air. So the microbes live in the air. So like this, there are shaded. Microbes do not like direct sunlight. Again, microbes do not like direct sunlight. So they live in shaded area. In your house, in this area, in those shaded portion of your farm, that's where the microbes are, in the air, initially. Now, the microbes in the air had many kinds, many varieties. Microbes is divided into two categories, the beneficial and the non-beneficial. Now, we'll discuss this later on. So, initially, they are in the air. Next, they are in the soil and in the waters. Again. There are microbes in the soil and also in the waters. The microbes in the soil and in the waters, the waters can be the salt water or fresh water. So both of them have microbes. Now, these microbes in the soil are different from the microbes in the air. It can be different. So there are also beneficial and non-beneficial in the soil and in the waters. Okay? Now, the microbes is not only in the soil, in the waters. They are also in the vegetation. From the roots to the trunk, branches, leaves, flowers, fruits, buong katawan, the whole body of the plants is filled up with all microbes, beneficial and non-beneficial. Claro? So, timbok, lawas, ng tanong. Na beneficial sa non-beneficial microbes. The microbes, lastly, they are also in life form. From the smallest life form hanggang to the biggest life form, sa sulod inside their body, there are many kinds of microbes, beneficial and non-beneficial. Clear? Now, regarding this beneficial and non-beneficial, we have to understand this. In the environment, there is always a positive and negative. It cannot be only positive, it cannot be only negative. The positive and negative should be there. In the Chinese, we call it the yin and yang. Kailangan, it's important sa the whole environment, there is negative, there is positive, and there is negative. But their balance is not this balance. Hindi pwede ganon. It cannot be this balance. The balance should be this. This is the balance. This is the positive, this is the negative. Or this is the beneficial, this is the non-beneficial. When the balance is this balance, you will have problems. Why? Because the non-beneficial grow faster than the beneficiary. Again, the non-beneficiary grow faster than the beneficiary. So if this is their balance, and they grow fast when there are high moisture content. It means when it rains, wow, this double time production. So this becomes the balance. When this happens, my God, there will be attacks. There will be disaster. There will be sickness and diseases. When this is the balance. Clear? The balance should be this one. Because the beneficial controls the non-beneficial. Again. The beneficial controls the non-beneficial. What did I say about microbes? They are soul gel. They are soul gel. So they control the non-beneficial. So they should be more. They should be less. For them to control. But if this is the balance, this grow fast, wow. They cannot control it anymore. Because they are less. Clear?
So basically, we have three types. The positive, negative, and one which is this, it's neutral.
No, the beneficial and non-beneficial, just two.
Okay.
Now, the balance should be this balance, not this balance, because this is a dangerous balance.
So non-beneficial is negative, the negative.
Yes.
Okay.
So the problem with the non-beneficial, they grow very fast than the beneficial. That's the characteristic, especially when there is high moisture content. They increase much faster with high moisture content. That's why after every heavy rain, if this is not their balance and this is their balance, then you will have problem. Then there will always be a virus attack, a fungus attack. See? Clear?
Yeah.
You have to understand all these principles because this is the knowledge that you are going to start the farm. You will understand already with this knowledge, you will understand already
so,
what's wrong.
Saan ba niyo pag-verify na mas daghan ang kantong
masama?
Katong, o katong
beneficial. Hindi ko na, may sakit na yung tanong niyo.
So, diyan na lang mo maribawaan kung may sakit na. So unsa ang manimo kanang tanong ang manimo ta kanang madetect na nimo daan mentras dili pa okay.
So with this understanding, what should you do to protect your farm?
So,
because in natural farming we believe in prevention is better than cure. If you prevent, there is no curing. If you prevent, there is no curing because there is no attack. You prevent. Now, how do you do it? You increase this one. Simple.
Increase the microorganisms.
Padaghan mo to. Pagdaghan ito, hindi na ito mo daghan. Kasi control na niya.
Pero you said before na ang microorganism is in the air, yes. Or like one, pero oh niya. So how can you identify to ang tao ni mo pag detect na mas daghan ang tuan nga kaysa kay parihaman sila sa tuan.
Listen, in your farm, what are you going to do? I said prevention is better than cure. So what are you going to do? You increase this one. There is no curing because there will be no attacks.
Magpadaghan ka good microorganism. Oh, magyong umandag fertilizer o niya. Oh, you will learn unsa ang unsa'y gamitin mo.
Magdaghan to, hindi magkaroon ng sakit.
I can't understand that again, kuya.
Oh, kabalo niya.
Kabalo na.
Simple as that. You increase this one, you control this one. If this is the balance, then you will have half of, because this will increase. That's why you increase this one. That's the key. Prevention is better than cure. If you prevent, there is no curing, because this won't increase, because this will control them. So wala ka lang sakit. There's no curing. Understood?
Yes.
Prevention.
Kasi sir, he is a farmer.
Yes.
And his plants will be attacked by so many insects, yes, and diseases.
We will teach you everything, don't worry. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, now we will have our breaks. Again, we will be eating again. We will be eating 5 times a day.
Natural farming food?
Not so right now, because we had limited chicken that are available by our students. So anyway, Miranda, you will have your snacks. Go and go to the dining room and have your snacks. Come on, guys.